Hi, and welcome to the 15th episode of China Tools. My name is Dennis, and I am from Hooked on Wood. This is my 15th episode, and I really think that is amazing. And of course, I could not imagine that when I started with my first episode. So this is a bit of an anniversary episode, and because of that, I show you some new products, and I want to give you my personal favorites of the last 15 episodes. In this episode, not very fancy products, but again, very practical products that every woodworker needs. That are these nice corner squares, a practical glue set, and two digital level boxes I want to tell you something about. I want to start with these corner squares. And this is not the first time I talked about these clamping squares. In episode 5, I also showed you these clamping squares, which are among the most used items in my shop. And I rewarded these clamps 5 stars, and I use these clamps for a lot of purposes. As a helping hand to assemble projects, when I want to give some pressure on a workpiece when gluing it so it does not shift, and of course when you want to align pieces of wood at exactly 90 degrees. What I like particularly about these corner clamp holders is that you can use them to make a jig for assembling drawers. And if you want to know more about this clamp, you have to watch episode 5. When Ben Good asked me if I would test these, I had my doubts in the beginning. The price is around $23, and I did not think they would be interesting enough because of that. But when they arrived, I immediately saw why they are more expensive. The fit and finish is very nice, and they are just of a higher quality. But they also come delivered with 2 of these small clamps. The packaging is very good and underscores the quality of these clamps. I asked for the 120mm version, and I see it as a benefit that they are a bit larger. I underestimated how easy these little clamps work. The clamping mechanism is very simple but effective. And I still like to use these clamps, but when you want to adjust 2 pieces, these clamps give you the most control and are easier to use. The biggest advantage of a combination of square and these clamps is that you can attach this clamp in the square middle with these holes. And that makes it possible to very easily clamp 2 pieces of wood together when you want to make a cabinet, for example. And this would not be possible this way with other clamps. Another advantage is that these clamps are very light and easy to use with smaller projects. There's a scale on the side in inches and millimeters to set up the height of your table saw blade or router. But although possible, there are better tools for that. It's difficult for me to check the scale, but I believe the scale is good. But the beginning of the scale is a little bit off and therefore not 100% accurate. If you hold it against my lab quality reference square, we see that it is very accurate. But be aware, these clamp squares are not precision squares. The tolerances are higher than with a precision square, but I found them remarkably accurate. I do not feel any play with both of the squares inside as outside. If I compare them with the clamps I used in episode 5, these are a bit more accurate. To summarize these corner squares and clamps, they are of a very good quality, and the clamps are an excellent addition to these corner squares. They cost around $23 for the 100mm version, and although that is not cheap, they are worth every penny if you ask me. This is the 120mm version, and I see the benefits from a little bit bigger corner square. In fact, I like them so much that I even bought 6 extra. And this is my scoring card. At the moment of the release of this video, Ben Good has a sales festival, the Double 11 festival from the 11th of November. And that is a big thing, and I know that these clamps cost now during this festival only $70 for a 100mm version. And I think that is a fantastic price. If you visit Ben Good more often or watch my video and later press my links, you will notice that prices change on Ben Good pretty often. Sometimes a few dollars, sometimes more. And I often visit their site because of this series, and sometimes I see prices drop so far that I found it almost insanely inexpensive. For example, this router radius jig. It was around $55 during my review, and I rewarded it for 4.5 stars because mainly of its price. But I saw it later on sale for $35. And then I thought, should I mention it in my next video? Because this is an unbelievable low price for this tool with this quality. But I never did this because I do not want to change my videos in a commercial. But only in this episode I want to make an exception. So forgive me. Because of the Double 11 Festival, this corner router jig is now only $28. And I think that is a fantastic low price for this quality. Between the products I test this episode, I also want to show you some personal favorites of the last 15 episodes. This tool is the reason I started my China Tool series. It's a curve maker and I was so impressed with the quality that I felt that I had to show it to you. At that time it was very low priced for only $21. And I never saw that price again. It's a very nice tool to measure the width of a groove. And if you want to know how it works, you have to watch episode 1. You can use it with your table saw, your router, your miter saw. It's just a very versatile tool. And now it's only $21. And because of my 15th episode anniversary, they made an even better price for my viewers for just $18. And you can find the coupon code in the description of the video. One other absolute favorite is this cabinet drawer drill guide. It's not a tool that I use a lot, but it is a fantastic product from a build quality point of view. It works very easy to add bars to a drawer, and you can see this product in episode 10. And it was $36 at my review time, and I think this is a very interesting price because the quality will impress you, the packaging is the best, and it is easy and accurate to use. Now the Double 11 price is just $27, and because of my 50th anniversary, they even lowered that price to $26 for my viewers. That is a ridiculously low price if you ask me. One of my most used products, and a product I absolutely 100% trust, my favorite T-ruler. I still prefer to use it over my Inca ruler, mainly because of the wider holes that give you better view when you want to add markers. I even bought all 3 sizes lately because I like this product so much. I always was a bit afraid that the longer one would bend if you use it, but that is no problem. During my review it was around $80, and on this moment during the Double 11 sales it's just $13, and for my viewers only $12. Next products are these digital level meters. These products came from your suggestions, and I asked Banggood if they could send me a cheap one and a more expensive one so I could compare those two products with each other and see if there are any differences between those digital level meters. First, let me explain what you can do with them. I think most people use them for setting up the angle of your table saw blade, but you can use them for more tools. In fact, it is a very nice tool to upgrade a lot of your tools. If you have a sander, you can set the angle of your platform very easy and exact. And especially with this kind of equipment, the scale is not that accurate. And that is why I think it is an easy upgrade for those kind of tools. But also to set up the angle of your bandsaw, your miter saw, and of your jointer. Sometimes you have not much space to level a tool, and because these products are so small, you can easily put them on somewhere and see if it is appropriately aligned. So a very nice and simple to add device that gives you a good angle reading. There are some differences between these two products, and the most affordable one costs $14. And it is strangely enough the most comprehensive. It had magnets on all sides, so you can also place them at the underside of a table or at the side of a saw blade, and in some situations that is convenient. The magnets are not strong if you compare that to the other one, but they are strong enough and you can get them easily off. So you could say that is a good point, but I prefer the stronger magnets of this device. It's pretty big, it has a big screen, but I do not think the size is an advantage. I like the size of the little one more. That gives the most flexibility. The sides are not totally flat, and sometimes that is an advantage when the surface you want to adjust is a bit dirty. It can measure the angle but also the slope in millimeters and foot. This is a very nice looking level meter, and it's by far the nicest one and looks and feel as the one with the best quality. It costs around $34 and it has a stainless steel cover. If you see them next to each other, there's no doubt which one is more expensive. I like its look, I like its size, and its display is good to read. It has 3 batteries inside, and that is a lot. The other has only 1. And I don't think it uses more power, so I assume it will operate for a longer time. But if you are interested and you want to order, be aware that some vendors offer this model with no batteries included. And if you use my link in the description, you get the one with the batteries included. It can only measure the angle in absolute and relative measurements. Both have a flip screen, which means that they flip the numbers at a certain degree for easy readings. So these are amazing handy tools, and the question is, how accurate are they and are they useful? And for this I want to check them at different angles, and I want to check the repeatability. Both have a resolution of 1/10 of a degree, so the second zero behind the comma stays zero, and that is a bit strange. But 1/10 is not a bad thing, because I also have one with a resolution of 1/100 of a degree, which becomes too nervous, and it is tough to get that one on a specific number. Both have a claimed accuracy of plus minus 0.2 degree, and that is an accuracy you see on almost all the level meters. I have a pretty expensive digital spirit level meter, and this one also have an accuracy of 0.2 degree. To measure the accuracy, I first hold these 2 level meters against my Stabila level meter, and I was surprised how close they were to this device. But of course, although the Stabila is more expensive, it also has an accuracy of 0.2 degrees. So I wanted to measure it against different angles that I could trust. And I have to say that in most of the cases, both of the level meters gave the exact right angle. The only problem I found is that they are not consistent enough. So one time they give the right measurement and another time it's a bit off. I also want to look for the repeatability, and therefore I tried different angles a few times to see if the reading will be consistent. And I have to say that the more expensive one is more consistent. Here it is 1/10 off, but at least it does it every time. Most of the time the maximum deviation was only 1/10 of a millimeter. And to give you an idea how much this is, I set up the table saw blade at exactly 90 degrees. And when I turn it a little bit, you can see how much deviation 1/10 of a degree gives. So after a lot of testing, my conclusion is that they are not high precision instruments. They lack consistency for that. And I could easily make or break these products in this video, because they give the exact readings in 70% of the time, and sometimes they are a little bit off. And I'm pretty sure that everyone that wants to sell you these products only will show you how perfectly accurate they are. And the fact is, they are not. If they were off for 90% of the time, the deviation was around 1/10 of a degree. But this does not make it a bad product. You only must be realistic and aware of it. The best way to set up your table saw blade at 90 and 45 degrees is with a good square or miter square. That is the only way to set up your blade accurate and consistent. But of course, we do not have a miter square for every angle, and then these boxes are a very good alternative. Because although not perfect, they are still more accurate than an average scale on your table saw or other tool. In fact, what surprised me is that they were not that much off when you compare them to my Stabila Spirit level meter. So if you hold these against each other, it's hard to tell which is more accurate. In the end, I compared them with my Stabila level meter and I made around 20 different measurements. And the stainless steel version had an average deviation of around 0.08 of a degree, and the affordable one of 0.11 of a degree. As I say in the beginning, the affordable one is more comprehensive and can also measure the slope. But if I test this, it was way off in the beginning and not useful. And although I was surprised how well it measured against the Stabila, it looks and feels a bit as a digital level meter of $14, which of course it is. And this is my scoring card. The stainless steel version looks very nice. I like its size because it's small. The magnets are stronger, what I like. And the underside is flat, and I prefer that. It has three batteries, so a longer operational time. And as far as I could measure it, the accuracy is good and within the declared values. But sometimes it reacted a bit slower. It measures only the angle, but does that very well for such a device. And this is my scoring card. Another product I could hardly live without are these Precision Square and this Miter Square. This square is a lab quality square and I tested it in episode 7 and it is very precise. At the time of the review it cost $15. Both give me the best setup for the different styles I have and because of that my cuts are accurate. I still prefer this Miter Square over the Inca Square and I found it much more practical and that for only $23. As you saw before, only this kind of squares guarantee a consistent and accurate setup. For the level of precision, I found them very nice priced, but with the Double 11 Festival, they become even more attractive with $13 for the square and $18 for the Miter Square. Number 5 is this Miter Gauge. A very nice Miter Gauge, but also from a very good quality. For $70 at the time of the review, it has a pretty hefty price tag. But I'm still very happy with it. It's very universal and you can add most fences on the market. I mainly use it as a Miter Gauge for my router table and I find it accurate and stable. You can find more over this Miter Gauge in episode 11. And now with the Double 11 Festival, it costs $58 and I think that is a very nice price. Last favorite I want to mention is this height gauge. I really like this tool and I use it in almost every project, mainly to set up the height of my router, but I also have used it this way with my bandsaw. I tested it in episode 6 and 7 against a very high quality industrial height gauge and the results were impressive for a device of around $44. Unfortunately, the price during the Double 11 Festival is still $42, what is still a very nice price if you ask me. Last product is this silicon glue kit set. It's a product that is not that much to talk about and I did not have it before and I have to say that it is a very nice product. I would almost consider it as an essential tool because it makes some work much easier. With the kit you can do a wide variety of work. If you have to glue big surfaces you can use the scraper and you have two brushes, a small one and a wider one, and both have a small flat scraper on the other side. The glue stays relatively long liquid between these silicone brushes. After a few hours the glue starts to crumble and you have to clean it. It's practical to put some glue in the glue tray and then glue some dovetails. If the glue is dry, it is easy to remove. And after a while I felt so confident that I thought these brushes were unbreakable, which is not the case. So you need some care. And although the bristles are very strong, they have a breaking point. It's much easier to clean these brushes with water at the end of the day. It's cleaner and afterwards they look like new. I like the kit very much and I found it a way better solution than using a putty knife or your finger as I did before. And this is my scoring card. Well, that was the 15th episode of China Tools. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a nice day. Stay safe and we'll see each other next time.